guys, how's it going? Brad here. Thanks for joining me on another beer review. Appreciate it. And tonight, having a look at another one from the Big Rock Brewery, part of their Swinger Pack, released here for spring. Purple Gas. Reminds me of Corner Gas for some reason. I like that show. I enjoyed it when it was on. Okay, 5.2% ABV. It's a beer of Saskatoon berries and agave nectar. Golden Alberta wheat, vibrant Saskatoon berries, and a delectable agave combine to fuel big thirsts. That's Purple Gas Ale. This prairie delight achieves its smooth taste by balancing the tartness of the berries with the sweetness of agave, while pumping its tank full of Alberta wheat, providing an alcohol content of 5.2% ABV. 5.2%. I don't know what I said. Anyway, using my my old Big Rock glass, it's the McNally Winter Spice Ale. Like when it first came out, it came with two glasses, four beer, and some ginger cookies. I fell in love with it at the time, man, I really did. And that got me into trying all kinds of beer. So anyway, again, I gotta thank Christy and Nick as well from Big Rock Brewery, because, you know, they hooked me up with this, and man, I really appreciate it. So very cool. This is one of the new beers in the pack. This and the dark ale, or the Paradox Dark Light Ale are the two new ones. And yeah, excited to try this one and get into it. Let you guys know what I think of it. Let's get it poured. There we go. You guys look. Yeah, super clear. You get that yellow, you know, that straw, golden, light yellow color. A bit of a soda pop, kind of that fizzy head on top. It's quite carbonated, it looks quite carbonated. I wasn't sure. I thought maybe be a bit purple, or like have a bit of a hue from the fruit in there. But yeah, it looks like it looks just that nice yellow straw color. Anyway, let's check out the aroma on the Purple Gas. Okay, like they say on here, they do hit it with that Alberta wheat, and yeah, that's the first thing I pick up on the aroma. I get that wheat malt for sure. I haven't done that in a while. Dip right in there. Maybe there is a bit of that berry in it, but it's definitely behind the wheat. I'm getting that up front. Yeah, I guess I was expecting that berry to come out more, or be a little more predominant, but let's get into it, guys. Okay, it's really nice. It is a nice beer. It is the light mouthfeel, light body, crisp, refreshing beer. But on the flavor, I want to say I do get that wheat malt up front, and then like the, Saskatoon berries and the agave. That's kind of like an underlying sweetness there. It's not up front. And I don't even, I would say I wouldn't even know there was really berries in it, but there is that kind of nice underlying sweetness. And a bit on the, yeah, the finish and the aftertaste, maybe it comes out a bit there. Yeah, really, really nice though, really easy drinking. I think I'm enjoying this. I'd say I'm almost enjoying this over their grasshopper. This is really good. But again, for like the wheat fruit beer, yeah, I wasn't sure how it'd play out. You know, some, like, I don't know, say I've had some raspberry wheat beers where it's like that over the top extract artificial fruit flavor that just kills the fucking beer. Whereas this, it's a very subtle note of the berries and more letting the wheat shine through, our Alberta wheat. So, you know, they're not trying to be one of those that are just overwhelming with the fruit, but it is a little subtle. And I guess it is hard to hit that perfect point. I mean, I've made a blueberry wheat beer, raspberry wheat beers, like lots of fruit wheat beers, and it was a learning curve for me because I fucked up a few batches of beer where I ended up with a wine cooler. But my last one I did, it was a blueberry cream ale, and I fucking nailed it because that was a good beer. But anyway, back to Big Rock, sorry guys. But yeah, this beer, this isn't gonna offend anybody. This is a very easy drinking, sessionable, definitely a sessionable, 5.2%. Man, I did enjoy the hell out of a case of this beer on a weekend, summer day, no problem. Very good. Again, like they're most of their beer, very clean, they're crisp, it's a well-crafted beer. Only complaint I would say is maybe I want the berries to come through a little bit stronger. But that's just me. Some people might pick it up stronger than me, I don't know. But for me, I want it, yeah, a little more on the fruit. But still really good beer. Yeah, not too bad at all. You know, I'd like to see this as a year-round from Big Rock, because it's pretty damn good. Yeah, Purple Gas. Not too bad. Not too bad at all. Let's rate this. Let's rate it, guys. Yeah, pretty good. Pretty good little beer. I'm gonna give it a 75. It's pretty awesome. Just wish, you know, it's should be a seasonal, or not just seasonal, year-round, sorry, year-round beer. Anyway, thank you for watching. I appreciate it, guys, and thanks again to Christy and Nick from Big Rock. Appreciate that, too. Till next time, cheers.